But if you're lucky enough and you have an environment where you can produce the research that you're passionate about, you have your dream job. Yeah. You create it. My name is Dr. Ioannis Savas Pantelidis. I am a director of doctoral studies at the University of Brighton. My PhD was on online consumer behavior and locus of control. I was measuring a particular personality construct and how personality characteristics might affect how consumers are booking hotel rooms online. You know, each research, the piece of research is actually you getting all the elements and putting them together for other people. So you're telling a story with evidence and hopefully with real impact that makes a difference in the lives of people. That's why I'm talking about storytelling. And it's pointless to me if I do the most amazing research that I can't explain to my grandma. And I always bring grandma in when I talk to my students and say, okay, so how do you say that to your grandma or your nephew who's like 5 years old? And that's where sometimes maybe some academics lose the storytelling, where they, you know, they come up with these amazing pieces of research that they don't then disseminate in the press. And it's important for PhD students, when they finish their PhD, they do publications in academic journals, but they also write up something in the particular press that there will be people of industry that they research that they will benefit from what they found out. Because I get excited with projects, and I was doing in the middle of my PhD, I wrote a book and wrote other papers, nothing to do with my PhD. Don't do it that way. I used to do 3 steps forward, 2 steps backwards. So I made a lot of the classic mistakes. Like, for example, I read a lot, but didn't write because I thought, oh, I've got special time to write. And then, of course, work was heavy as well. So 3 months later, I had to go and reread what I read 3 months ago to write. A lot of mistakes, which hopefully make me a better supervisor, because now I know what to tell my students not to do. But it took 7 years. You know, it took a lot of pain and sweat, and it took a lot of, how shall I put it? It looked at some moments of real reflection of whether I wanted to finish this thing. Because I reached a point where the pain was too much. The mental pain, if you like. And there was moments, you know, I'm not going to lie to you, there were moments where I wanted to lit up the fireplace and put the whole thesis in. And luckily, you know, these things are not achieved by a single person. Maybe I'm the doctor, but the PhD belongs to my wife. You know, you've got, if you surround yourself with people, your family, your friends, that love you and embrace you, even through the bad days, they're your strength, they're your batteries. It has become easier in terms of being able to have a schedule where you can do more stuff than before. But then, of course, what you have the loneliness. You know, it's a different thing. We talk now through a digital medium. It wouldn't be the same if we were, you know, sitting in a room, sharing a cup of a coffee and, you know, just chilling. It's very different. And the body language is something that I miss. And even the eye contact, you know, you try to make eye contact through this medium, it's not the same. So for PhD students, they're the pressures of feeling alone, especially if they left their country and they're in some small room somewhere and they feel they can't go out. But what I say is you can even take a break and go around the building. And even if you see a few bodies walking about, it makes it real again. And I say find tools that help you ground yourself in the reality. Always remember that your PhD is this little thing in the great vastness of things. So don't, because you're in it, you think it's everything. Keep, you know, if you look at some of the great researchers, the great inventors, the great anything, they did a lot of things. You know, they played music, they went dancing, they went sailing. I think Einstein did sailing, played violin, if I remember correctly. because you need to allow your body and your mind downtime. You can't be, you know, we cannot always be 100% productive all the time. And you need to find these other things that keep you balanced and grounded and sane.